What you guys, got another video here for you. In this one we're going to be looking at how we can fix the error or blue screen of death, as it's known, on a Windows 8 machine or Windows 8.1 machine called system thread exception not handled. Now sometimes you get a bracket on the end which actually gives you the .sys file, and sometimes you don't. Okay, so you might not see this .sys file. Now it also, you can see the .sys file is called atikmdag.sys. Now there's about 10 other .sys files that it could be, so it might not be the same as this one, but this error will be the same. Okay, system thread exception not handled. Now if you're running a Windows 7 machine, you will have a slightly different blue screen. It may look something like this, and sometimes they don't stick on the screen, sometimes they just quickly flash and change. Okay, so if you want to see what that reads, you can always change those settings. Okay, and what we're going to do here is diagnose and fix this issue. It's pretty straightforward. So now we're back at the desktop here. What we want to do here is we need to get into safe mode on our Windows 8 or Windows 8.1 machine, and we're going to be uninstalling the graphics drivers now. Okay, so if you want to uninstall this driver manually, you can do that in Device Manager. There's numerous different ways to get into Device Manager, but we're going to show you this way. We can click on the tab here, like so, and then you see here this PC, or it'll be whatever you've called it. Right click this and you want to click Manage. Okay, and this will open up this box, Computer Management. From there you can see Device Manager, and this will open up Device Manager. Okay, another way to quickly do it, I'll just quickly show you, is right click on the Start button here, and you can look up in here and you'll see Device Manager here, and this will just open this up straight away, like so, depending on which way you want to go about it, but it's both the same. Now once you're inside here, as you can see, this is your machine here. Now what you're looking for is display adapters, and a display adapter, as you can see, is a virtual box graphics adapter here in this case, but what we're going to be looking for on yours, it will be AMD or NVIDIA, and it will have the name of your graphics card here. Okay, now you could right click on this and uninstall it this way if you wanted to, or you can use the method that I'm going to use. Now also you can come into the properties area here, and you can also see driver, and there's an option here to roll back the driver, and this is another good way of trying to go to an older version of the driver in case there's an issue like that as well. But if you want to uninstall it, that's what I'd advise you to do, is click uninstall and get rid of it, and then download the latest version before you do all this. Okay, so first off you want to get onto the internet and get your driver. So if, as long as it's not completely blue screening all the time, you can do this option. So you want to get on the internet and go to your NVIDIA, and then type NVIDIA in here, and then you can click on drivers, and then you can get the latest drivers for you. And the same thing for AMD. Pick out your graphics card, you'll know which graphics card you've got, and then you select here, and then you download them drivers. Okay, you do a search and it will let you download those drivers. Once you've got the latest drivers, you're pretty much good to go. Same thing for AMD, just type AMD in there and you get your drivers. Now once you've got your drivers, you want to get into safe mode. Okay, so now we've got our driver on our desktop ready to go, and what we're going to do is get into safe mode. Now Windows 8 or Windows 8.1 is a bit more trickier. As long as you can get to the desktop for a little while, you can actually get into safe mode. We're going to go to the run here by right clicking on the start button, type in here msconfig, just like I've got here, click OK, and once you're inside here, you want to go to the boot tab here. On the boot tab there should be a little boot options here. Now once you've finished this, you will need to remove this, but this will allow you to boot straight into safe mode. Okay, I'm going to apply this and OK, and then restart the system. Okay, so we'll just let this load in. Now we're at the safe mode option here, and what we want to do here is, if you're going to be doing it this way, I would advise you to uninstall using the Display Driver Uninstaller. This is a great program for getting rid of all the remnants from all those display drivers. Click on this, okay, and then once you've got the Display Uninstaller, you can see there it's short for DDU, and we've got it selected on AMD at the moment. Now depending whether you've got an AMD graphics driver or NVIDIA, you would select which one you want. Once you've done that, okay, you can remove the C area here. This is what I'd advise you to do, because these remnants here will be having all those files in. So you want to make sure you get rid of everything. So put the tick inside here, the C AMD or the C NVIDIA folder. That will have all those .sys files in. You want to get rid of all of that stuff and replace it with a brand new graphics driver, okay? So depending on whether it's on AMD or NVIDIA, that's what you need to do here. Then click on this one up the top, clean and restart. That's highly recommended, and that will uninstall everything and remove all the remnants from that machine. Do that. Once you've done that, you're pretty much good to go. You can then reinstall your driver, which you've downloaded, reboot the system, and you should be okay. Now, before you go back to the desktop, you'll need to come into the run area here. So right click on the start button, type in msconfig and go back to that boot tab, and then remove that safe boot tick under the boot tab. Okay, restart. And you should be back at the desktop. You can run in your new driver if you wish. But once you do that, you can look in your device manager, and you should have a new install of that driver now. And hopefully this will eradicate your issue that you're having with that blue screen. Okay, now monitor it and see what happens and see how it goes. Now, if the blue screens go away, you fix the problem. If you're still getting issues after this, then there's something more sinister. Okay, now if you're overclocking your graphics card, you want to drop that down to stock settings and do not overclock until you diagnose the problem. Okay, if you're still having problems after that, it's time to start searching for hardware issues. It could be your graphics cards failing, could be memory issues, could be all sorts of things like that. But this is the first steps that you want to do to make sure you can eradicate any issues with that blue screen there. Okay, anyway, I'm going to wrap this one up. My name is Brian from brightechcomputers.co.uk. If you enjoy these videos, guys, then hit the thumbs up button. It really does help me out. And also hit the subscribe button if you want to keep up to date when I upload new videos. Also, if you've got any problems with your computers, you can always head over to my forums and post on there, and we can help you out over there. Or if you've got any questions or you want to contact me, then the forums is the place to go, and the information's up on the screen right now. Okay. Anyway, have a great day, and I shall see you again in the next video. Bye for now.